This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Criticism of Microsoft has followed various aspects of its products and business practices. Issues with ease of use, robustness, and security of the company's software are common targets for critics in the 2000s. A number of malware mishaps have targeted security flaws in Microsoft Windows and other programs. Microsoft is also accused of locking vendors and consumers into their products, and of not following and complying with existing standards in its software. Total cost of ownership comparisons of Linux to Windows are a continuous point of debate. The company has been the subject of numerous lawsuits by several governments and other companies for unlawful monopolistic practices. In 2004, the European Union found Microsoft guilty in the European Union Microsoft competition case. Additionally, EULAs for Microsoft programs are often criticized as being too restrictive. Contents: 1. Vendor lock-in, 2. Copyright enforcement, 3. Licensing agreements, 4. Acquisitions, 5. Litigation, 6. Labor practices, 7. Advertising and public relations, 8. Blacklisting of journalists, 9. Censorship in China, 10. Collaboration with the NSA on internet surveillance, 11. Worker productivity software, 12. Gay reference controversy, 13. Website concerns, 14. Workforce diversity, 15. See also, 16. References, 17. Footnotes, 18. External links, 181. Related media. Vendor lock-in. From its inception, Microsoft defined itself as a platform company and understood the importance of attracting third-party programmers. It did so by providing development tools, training, access to proprietary APIs in early versions, and partner programs. Although the resulting ubiquity of Microsoft software allows a user to benefit from network effects, critics decry what they consider to be an embrace, extend, and extinguish strategy by Microsoft of adding proprietary features to open standards, thereby using its market dominance to gain unofficial ownership of standards extended. In this way, Microsoft software is also presented as a safe choice for IT managers purchasing software systems. In an internal memo for senior management, Microsoft's head of C development, Aaron Contour, stated, "The Windows API is so broad, so deep, and so functional that most independent software vendors would be crazy not to use it, and it is so deeply embedded in the source code of many Windows apps that there is a huge switching cost to using a different operating system. Instead, it is this switching cost that has given the customers the patience to stick with Windows through all our mistakes, our buggy drivers, our high TCO total cost of ownership, our lack of a sexy vision at times, and many other difficulties. Customers constantly evaluate other desktop platforms. It would be so much work to move over that they hope we just improve Windows rather than force them to move. In short, without this exclusive franchise called the Windows API, we would have been dead a long time ago." More recently, Microsoft had their OOXML specification approved by the ISO standards body in a manner consistent with previous attempts to control standards. Copyright enforcement: when Microsoft discovered that its first product, Altair Basic, was subject to widespread unauthorized copying, Microsoft founder Bill Gates wrote an open letter to hobbyists that openly accused many hobbyists of stealing software. Gates' letter provoked many responses, with some hobbyists objecting to the broad accusation, and others supporting the principle of compensation. This disagreement over whether software should be proprietary continues into the present day under the banner of the free software movement, with Microsoft characterizing free software released under the terms of the GPL as being potentially viral, and the new general public license itself as a viral license, which infects proprietary software and forces its developer to have to release proprietary source to the public. The Halloween documents, internal Microsoft memos which were leaked to the open source community beginning in 1998, indicate that some Microsoft employees perceive open source software, in particular Linux, as a growing long-term threat to Microsoft's position in the software industry. The Halloween documents acknowledge that parts of Linux are superior to the versions of Microsoft Windows available at the time, and outlined a strategy of decommoditize protocols, Active Directory, and Windows Media that sell as part of Windows but compete with application software licensing agreements. Main article: bundling of Microsoft Windows. A common complaint comes from those who want to purchase a computer that usually comes pre-installed with Windows without a copy of Windows pre-installed and without paying extra for the license, either so that another operating system can be used or because a license was already acquired elsewhere, such as through the MSDN Academic Alliance program. Microsoft encourages original equipment equipment manufacturers OEMs to supply computers with Windows pre-installed by presenting their dominance in computer sales and arguing that consumers benefit by not having to install an operating system because the price of the license varies depending on discounts given to the OEM and because there is no similar computer that the OEM offers without Windows. There is no immediate way to find the size of the refund. In 2009, Microsoft stated that it has always charged OEMs about $50 for a Windows license on a $1,000 computer. While it is possible to obtain a computer with no or free operating systems, virtually all large computer vendors continue to bundle Microsoft Windows with the majority of the personal computers in their ranges. The claimed increase in the price of a computer resulting from the inclusion of a Windows license has been called the Windows tax or Microsoft tax by opposing computer users. The findings of fact in the United States Microsoft antitrust case of 1998 established that one of the ways Microsoft combats piracy is by advising OEMs that they will be charged a higher price for Windows unless they drastically limit the number of PCs that they sell without an operating system pre-installed. In 1998, all major OEMs agreed to this restriction. Microsoft also once assessed license fees based on the number of computers an OEM sold, regardless of whether a Windows license was included. Microsoft was forced to end this practice due to a consent decree in 2010. Microsoft stated that its agreements with OEMs to distribute Windows are non-exclusive, and OEMs are free to distribute computers with a different operating system or without any operating system. Microsoft does not provide refunds for Windows licenses sold through an OEM, including licenses that come with the purchase of a computer or are pre-installed on a computer. According to Microsoft's end-user license agreement for Windows 7, the ability to receive a refund for the operating system is determined by the hardware manufacturer. By using the software, you accept these terms. If you do not accept them, do not use the software instead. Contact the manufacturer or installer to determine its return policy. You must comply with that policy, which might limit your rights or require you to return the entire system on which the software is installed. Acer has a policy of requiring the customer to return items at his or her own expense, and the balance received by the customer can be as low as €30. In other cases, vendors have asked that customers requesting refunds sign non-disclosure agreements. Older versions of Microsoft Windows had different license terms with respect to the availability of a refund for Windows. By using the software, you accept these terms. If you do not accept them, do not use the software instead. Contact the manufacturer or installer to determine their return policy for a refund or credit based on the updated language. Vendors refuse to issue partial refunds for Windows licenses, requiring that the computer be returned altogether in some countries. This practice has been ruled a violation of consumer protection law. Acquisitions. Microsoft has acquired several companies and products during its history, including some that competed with earlier Microsoft products. Such acquired assets include DOS Seattle Computer Products, Qdos, FrontPage, Vermeer Technologies Incorporated, FrontPage, WEB TV, now MSN TV, Hotmail, Direct3D, Internet Explorer, Spyglass, Inc., Mosaic, Vizio, Vizio Corporation, Vizio, Windows Virtual PC, Kinectix Virtual PC, and Windows Defender. Giant Company Software, Inc., Giant Anti-Spyware. Microsoft rebrands the primary products of the companies it acquires, and in many cases offers them for free or bundles them with their operating system. Former Sun Microsystems chief executive Scott McNeely occasionally remarked that Microsoft never produced technology except by buying it. Historically, Microsoft has also been accused of overworking employees, in many cases, leading to burnout within just a few years of joining the company. The company is often referred to as a velvet sweatshop, a term which originated in a 1989 Seattle Times article, and later became used to describe the company by some of Microsoft's own employees. This characterization is derived from the perception that Microsoft provides nearly everything for its employees in a convenient place, but in turn overworks them to a point where it would be bad for their possibly long-term health. For example, the kitchenettes have free beverages and many buildings include exercise rooms and showers. However, the company has been accused of attempting to keep employees at the company for unreasonably long hours and working them too much. This is detailed in several books about Microsoft, including Hard Drive, Bill Gates and the Making of the Microsoft Empire. A U.S. state lawsuit was brought against Microsoft in 1992 representing 8,558 current and former employees that had been classified classified as temporary and freelance, and became known as Vizcaino v. Microsoft in 1993. The suit became a U.S. federal class action in the United States District Court Western District of Washington at Seattle as No. C-93-178-C. The final settlement came in 2005. The case was decided on the IRS-defined basis that such permatomp had their jobs defined by Microsoft, worked alongside regular employees doing the same work, and worked for long terms after a series of court setbacks including three reversals. On appeal, Microsoft settled the suit for US$93 million. A side effect of the permatemp lawsuit is that now contract employees are prevented from participating in team morale events and other activities that could be construed as making them employees. They are also limited to one-year contracts and must leave after that time for 100 days before returning under contract. Microsoft is the largest American corporate user of H-1B guest worker visas and has joined other large technology companies like Google in recently lobbying for looser H-1B visa restrictions. Advertising and public relations critics have alleged that Microsoft has used funding to drum up support from think tanks and trade organizations such as the Alexis de Tocqueville Institution ADTI, the Independent Institute, and Americans for Technology Leadership ATL. During the antitrust case United States v. Microsoft, ATL sent a poll to 19 state attorneys general purporting to show that the public believes state AGs should devote their energy to causes other than Microsoft. Also during the case, the Independent Institute ran full-page advertisements in the New York Times and the Washington Post defending Microsoft, which was later revealed to have funded the ad campaign. The Institute published winners, losers, and Microsoft, Competition and Antitrust in High Technology shortly thereafter. A press release for a 2002 report by the ADTI claimed open-source software may offer target for terrorists. The report itself does not mention terrorism or how it would target open-source software, but does allege that open-source software may be more prone to security holes than proprietary software. It gives particular focus to GPL-licensed software, claiming that it is not cost-effective. In 2004, the ADTI announced a report, Samizdat, alleging that the creator of the Linux operating system Linus Torvalds based it on Minix. Minix creator Andrew S. Tannenbaum strongly refuted this claim. Microsoft has countered that it funds many think tanks besides the ADTI, such as the American Enterprise Institute, the Cato Institute, the Center for Strategic and International Studies, and the Heritage Foundation, and that it does not fund any specific research. In August 2004, the Advertising Standards Authority ASA of the United Kingdom ordered Microsoft to stop a run of print ads that claimed that the total cost of ownership of Linux servers was 10 times that of Windows Server 2003. The comparison included the cost of hardware, and put Linux at a disadvantage by installing it on more expensive but poorer performing hardware compared to that used for Windows. On January 22, 2007, Rick Jelliffe made a claim on his blog that a Microsoft employee offered to pay him to make corrections in English Wikipedia articles concerning Office Open XML. Microsoft spokesperson Catherine Brooker expressed the belief that the article had been heavily written by IBM employees who supported the rival open document format, though she provided no specific evidence. Internet entrepreneur and Wikimedia founder Jimmy Wales described Microsoft's offer as unethical in 2011. MoneyLifeIn alleged that two anonymous comments boosting their product, one by a Nokia employee and another by a Microsoft employee, were posted on their review of Nokia Lumia 800, which was based only on the technical specifications, and the reviewer hadn't laid a finger on the phone. In conclusion, Charles Arthur argued, "Nobody has come out of the episode looking good." Sip Kell was accused of breaking his own site's privacy policy by posting the IP and email addresses of the commenters, while the commenting duo's failure to declare any interest looked, at best, like astroturfing. In 2014, details on a partnership between Machinima.com and Microsoft came to light regarding a marketing campaign for Xbox One. Machinima would offer some of its users $3 per thousand views if the user showed 30 seconds of an Xbox One game and mentioned the system by name. Controversy arose when it was reported that, under the terms of the promotion, participants were not allowed to disclose that they were being paid for said endorsements, which Ars Technica said conflicted with FTC regulations requiring recipients to fully disclose when such actions occur. Machinima stated that the confidentiality clause only applied to the terms of the agreement, and not to the existence of the agreement, and Microsoft ended the promotion and directed Machinima to add disclosures to the videos involved in September 2015. Machinima settled with the FTC over charges that the ad campaign failed to comply with FTC endorsement guidelines. The FTC decided not to take action against Microsoft since it already has policies and procedures designed to prevent such lapses. Blacklisting of journalists. John C. Dvorak said that in the 1980s, Microsoft classified journalists as okay, sketchy, or needs work, and targeted needs work. Journalists, in an attempt to have them terminated, Dvorak said that he was denied information about Windows because he was on a blacklist. Mary Jo Foley stated that she was denied interviews with Microsoft personnel for several years following the publication of a story based on a memo describing the number of bugs in Windows 2000 at release. Censorship in China. Microsoft, along with Google, Yahoo, Cisco, AOL, Skype, and other companies, has cooperated with the Chinese government in implementing a system of internet censorship. Human rights advocates such as Human Rights Watch and media groups such as Reporters Without Borders criticized the companies, noting for example that it is ironic that companies whose existence depends on freedom of information and expression have taken on the role of censor. Collaboration with the NSA on internet surveillance. See also, _NSAKEY. Microsoft was the first company to participate in the PRISM surveillance program, according to leaked NSA documents obtained by The Guardian and The Washington Post in June 2013, and acknowledged by government officials following the leak. The program authorizes the government to secretly access data of non-US citizens hosted by American companies without a warrant. Microsoft has denied the participation in such a program in July 2013. The Guardian elaborated that leaked documents show that Microsoft helped the NSA to circumvent its encryption to intercept web chats on Outlook.com and gave it unencrypted access to Outlook.com and Hotmail email. Microsoft provided the NSA with access to users' data on its cloud storage service OneDrive, formerly SkyDrive, after Microsoft bought Skype. The NSA tripled the amount of Skype video calls being collected through PRISM in a statement. Microsoft said that they provide customer data only in response to legal processes. Worker productivity software. Microsoft has also come under criticism for developing software capable of analyzing the output of remote sensors in order to measure the competence and productivity of workers based on their physical responses. Gay reference controversy. Microsoft has come under some criticism for its attitude to homosexuality, and Xbox Live users may not use the string gay in a gamertag even in a non-homosexual context, for example as part of a surname, or refer to homosexuality in their profile including self-identifying as such, as the company considers this content of a sexual nature or offensive to other users and therefore unsuitable for the service after banning Teresa, a lesbian gamer who had been harassed by other users for being a homosexual. A senior Xbox Live team member, Stephen Toulouse, has clarified the policy, stating that expression of any sexual orientation is not allowed in gamertags, but that they are examining how we can provide it in a way that won't get misused. Glad weighed in on the controversy as well, supporting the steps that Microsoft has taken over the years to engage the LGBT community. Website concerns. Polish users of Microsoft's business productivity infrastructure website have noticed a white model face has been photoshopped over the head of the African-American model at center in the photograph on the main page of the Polish language version of the website. The website Photoshop Disasters covered the story on the 25th of August 2009 as of 1 a.m. Greenwich Mean Time on the 25th of August. This has been changed and the image on the Polish website now reflects the image on the English website. Microsoft later issued an apology regarding the incident. Spokesman Lou Jellos stated that Microsoft was looking into the details of this situation. The apology was later restated on Microsoft's official Twitter page. Marketing site photo mistake, sincere apologies, we're in the process of taking down the image. Workforce diversity. Jesse Jackson believes Microsoft should hire more minorities and women. Jackson has urged other companies to diversify their workforce. He believes that Microsoft made some progress when it appointed two women to its board of directors in 2015. See also criticism of other software companies. Criticism of Apple Inc. Criticism of Facebook. Criticism of Google. Criticism of Yahoo. General mechanisms at work. Path dependence. Embrace, extend and extinguish network effect. Vendor lock-in. Appeal to fear. Fear, uncertainty and doubt. References. Charles, John. Indecent proposal. Doing business with Microsoft. IEEE Software. January, February 1998. pp. New York, Viking, 1995. National Science Foundation 2003. Taking cues from Mother Nature to foil cyber attacks. Retrieved December 20, 2003, from http://usfgov/odd/lpa/news/03/pr031300htm. Bosman, Jean, Gillen, Al, Kalaji, Charles, Kuznetsky, Dan, Perry, Randy. Parmi Olson, Q. Ina Fried, Balmer on EU, Yahoo, CNET News, February 27, 2008. David Prosser, Microsoft fined record €899 million by EU over market abuse. The Independent, February 28, 2008. Footnotes carat Microsoft A History of Anti-Competitive Behavior and Consumer Harm, PDF. European Committee for Interoperable Systems, the 31st of March 2009. Retrieved the 25th of May 2009. Carat A. B. Erickson, Jonathan, the 22nd of July 2001. Embrace, extend, extinguish, three strikes and you're out. Dr. Dobbs Portal. Retrieved the 5th of February 2007. The 23rd of June 2009. Carat Buying Without Windows Don't Want Windows. Best Price Computers Limited. February 2007. Carat Microsoft Official Valued Customer Statement. Carat Cower de Cassation, Seville, Chambre Seville 1, 15 November 2010, 09-11161, Publier au Bulletin, November 15, 2010. Carat Senators, Companies with Mass Layoffs Shouldn't Hire More Foreign Workers. Carat Green, Thomas C. The 10th of June 2002, MS-funded think tank propagates open source lies. The Register. Retrieved the 8th of November 2012. Carat A. B. Arthur, Charles, the 18th of October 2011, Nokia and Microsoft fingered over comments on adverse Lumia review. London, The Guardian. Retrieved the 14th of January 2012. 2013. The 25th of February 2009. CNN.com, Microsoft, flaw left millions at risk. Flaw discovered by Faisal Donka. http://uis.gov/adder/cases/f3800/msjudgextim. Dissecting Microsoft, analyzes Microsoft's business practices and software, the Microsoft tax, by the Linux Information Project. LINFOFAQ on the Microsoft antitrust case by the Center for the Advancement of Capitalism. Novell, Sue's response to Steve Ballmer's letter to the Linux community. TCO study, Linux is still cheaper than Windows PC. WorldCom tax evasion, tax evasion by Microsoft in India. User feedback, an IT professional's testimonial of Microsoft software downfalls related. Media Gartner, Windows collapsing under own weight VE Microsoft history. All topics. People list. Founders Bill Gates, Paul Allen. Board of Directors John W. Thompson. Chairman Satya Nadella. CEO Dina Dublin. Maria Clave. David Marquardt. Charles Noska. Helmut Panka. Mason Morfitt. John W. Stanton. Senior Leadership Team Satya Nadella. CEO Scott Guthrie. Amy Hood. CFO Chi Lu. Terry Meyerson. Harry Shum. Kevin Turner. COO. Corporate VPs Joe Belfiore. Richard Rashid. SVPs Somasegar. SVP Divisions Engineering Groups. Mobile Skype Unit. Digital Crimes Unit. Garage Press Research Studios. Net Foundation. Outercurve Foundation. Estates. Microsoft Redmond Campus. Microsoft Tallo. Microsoft Algeria. Microsoft Egypt. Microsoft India. Microsoft Japan. Product Families. Operating Systems. Windows Software. Office Servers. Visual Studio Hardware. HoloLens. Lumia. Surface. Xbox. Web Properties. Bing. Channel 9. Codeplex. Developer Network. MSN. OfficeCom. OneDrive. OutlookCom. TechNet. Windows Store. Conferences. Build Mix. PDC Techt WinHack. WPC Criticism. Bundling of Microsoft Windows. Clippy ILU. Internet Explorer. Microsoft Bob _ NSAKEY. Windows 2000 ME XP Vista. Xbox 360 Litigation. Alcatel-Lucent v. Microsoft. Apple v. Microsoft. European Union. Microsoft Competition Case. Microsoft v. Lindos. Microsoft vs. Microsoft. Microsoft v. Shaw. United States v. Microsoft. Acquisitions 6. Wunderkinder. Altamira Software. Aquantive. Azixi. The Blue Ribbon. Soundworks. Bungie. Callista Technologies. Colloquy. Connectix. Consumers Software. Danger. Faircast. FASA Studio. Fast Search.